So, I've written a little library. It's called TinyGrad. You guys can find it here on GitHub. So this is kind of collaborative development. There's already an issue filed. If somebody could make the tests run in CI. There's two tests. You can just run them with test. We have the MNIST test, which trains that MNIST model. It's the exact same thing that we were doing yesterday, if you guys were paying attention, but it's written in my brand new deep learning framework called TinyGrad. And maybe we can this may not be the best deep learning framework, but it is a deep learning framework. Except it does tensor things. So I was just cleaning up. I figured I'd just come on stream and we could all play along. I was just cleaning up. I was refactoring my example. You see, we made this thing called Tiny Bobnet. And in Tiny Bobnet, we init the two layers, and then we have SGD. So we have two goals for this stream. And I'll put them in the README right now. Goal one, to do. Implement convolutions and implement Atom optimizer to make real neural network library. I can make the text a little bigger for you guys. Yeah, we're back in Vim. I know you guys like when we're back in Vim. Implement convolutions, implement Atom optimizer. So you like grad, you like micrograd, you'll love tiny grad. So someone suggested on yesterday's stream to check out Carpathy's Micrograd. And Carpathy's Micrograd is cool. You can install it on pip. The problem with Micrograd is Micrograd, they use values, and each value is only a single scalar value. It's not based on NumPy. So you can't do matrices very well with it. But in TinyGrad, we can do matrices. And if you're familiar with PyTorch, you'll see that my classes look pretty similar to PyTorch. We have a context, we have a tensor, and we have a function. And then you can implement functions here. So you implement the forward pass and the backward pass. And then my beautiful AutoGrad engine here, which is honestly terribly written and may start to break at some point, runs the backward passes. So you just run through the forward passes. You can see over here in Tiny Bobnet, here's the forward pass. So we take in the thing, we dot it with the first set of weights, we do the ReLU, we dot it with the second set of weights, and then we do the log softmax. I'm like, this is implemented down here. Here's your log softmax. That's the forward pass. That's the backward pass. Oh, yes. We should add one more thing to the to-do. We should also to-do implement grad check. Numeric. Because we want to check these gradients numerically. So I did write TinyGrad off stream, but it's so tiny that everybody should go read it right now. It's very tiny, and it's right there on GitHub, TinyGrad. And actually, you'll see that this ReLU syntax is almost identical to PyTorch. I've also been reading the PyTorch code. Over here, so this is the PyTorch code. But yeah, so this is how you define ReLU in PyTorch, and this is how you define ReLU in TinyGrad. Very similar, except you know it's like copy instead of clone, because we're modifying this in place. It's maximum instead of clamp. I don't think NumPy has a clamp. But yeah, so if torch is based on the torch tensor, tinygrad is based on the numpy array. We could probably just wrap numpy, to be honest, and just add these properties to numpies. That might be an improvement to tinygrad. So we don't have to make them into tensors all the time. But meh, who cares? We wrapped it with a tensor, and that'll allow us to change things out underneath. Increase the font size, bro. You suggested tinygrad on the... Oh, if you want details on the math behind autograd. Oh, let's see what we got. Mathematics for machine learning. Oh, seems hard. We're still on Python 3.8. Is 3.9 actually out? Not sure. But upgrading your Python won't make you a better programmer, only years and years and years of difficult practice will. I feel like I can not do so many transposes here if I just did less transposes and was more reasonable with it. Grad output dot weight dot t. But it's nice because you can do things like check that your grad shape matches your tensor shape, which is really good. Got to make sure we have a gradient for the backward pass. Yeah. We have this thing called context. And a context object is created every time. Actually, in Torch, it talked about how a function object is created. It's a static method. I can just do that. That's kind of cleaner. Is the context a function in PyTorch? Let's play along with this. Let me get my ReLU over here in PyTorch, and we can look at how they do it. PyTorch is really beautifully implemented. I'm so impressed by how nice everything is. So, that's not what I want. So we all know about ReLU and the gradient on ReLU. We learned this yesterday. Hopefully you guys studied yesterday's stream. If you didn't study yesterday's stream, you didn't do your homework. And if you didn't study yesterday's stream, you know, we're going to do a test for this one, too. No, I'm too lazy to put tests together. I'm not in New York anymore. We're here to code. We're here to go hard. Okay, let's go. MyRailU.apply. So let's just make a tensor. Let's say it's ones. Torch.tensor.ones. 10. What T? Built-in function. What? Oh, that's just torch.ones. What am I doing? Okay, cool. My ReLU dot apply to T, let's say TR. Well, it can't be all ones. Let's make a tensor. You know, we'll throw in a minus one and a one. Those are nice. Okay, so that's what happens when you apply a ReLU to minus one and one. And now we want to do a backwards pass. Let's just say tr.mean.backwards. And then here we'll say requires grad equals true. And we'll also print t.grad here. Oh, that's a tragedy. Okay, cool. All right, so when we take the gradient backwards, somehow it turned into 0.5. Oh, and that's because that's the mean, right? So the gradient across a mean is just going to be, you start with one, and then if you're taking a mean, you always start with one at the beginning of the backward pass. I think that's just because in the chain rule, you can always multiply anything by one. So you can see where I wrote that code in tinygrad. That code's written in tinygrad right here. So if self grad is none, we start with, we make sure it only starts with a single, it has to be an item. It has to be a single thing. This is true in PyTorch too. You'll see if I take out this mean, it gives an error. Grad can only be implicitly created for scalar outputs. I think I could actually make a gradient on there and then that gradient could backprop, but if you, this is just here. This is implicit gradient creation. Okay, so let's see what a CTX actually is. Oh, it's a function. Yeah, okay, good. Then actually it turns out that we only need two base classes. Okay, let's refactor this. This actually makes a lot more sense like this. Because, yeah, cool. So instead of creating a context, we just create an arc. Yeah, then we don't need this anymore. We want to apply. See, I'm putting in function apply, aren't I? Oh no, fxn.apply. Okay, that should be okay. Partial method fxn.apply. Let's see if this works. Oh, that one takes a long time to start. Let's bring the other test up. That one has to load PyTorch though. Sum has no attribute arg. Yeah, because we don't actually need arg here anymore. We can just print out the context. Oh, beautiful. The tests pass. Oh, that was so. Oh, that's such a nice refactor. The function is the context. See, this is what I mean. PyTorch is so beautifully thought out. Why am I printing all this junk? Where did I stick prints in? Oh, here. Print self. Why is self a tensor? It's fine. Who cares? Now partial method works. Self and arg are switched. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, I'm so happy about that. Okay, cool. Refactor tiny grad to be more tiny. So if you can see here, when I printed out CTX, it's a function type. Torch autograd function my relu backward. So actually we can do the same thing in tinygrad, and we'll see what happens. So we can actually go to the real definition of relu here. And we can print out CTX. I expect it to also be a type function. Well, okay, it's a tinygrad tensor relu. Huh. I'll take it. I mean, it's a subclass of function. So this is effectively that CTX is then effectively self. It's a static method, so I have to call it with that. Yeah. Cool. Let's read and see how PyTorch does it. Good thing he does not read chat and there are no admins. All right, you want a little slightly bigger on the text? Is everyone happy? Now you're going to make me put an enter in here. It's gross. Go to page 162 of this book. I lost the book link. I'm in my mom's basement. I'm not sure this is the kind of automatic differentiation that I have. Sorry, I can't use computers today. Slow, 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 slow. Okay. What page you say? 162. Automatic differentiation. Turns out that backpropagation is a special case of a general technique in numeric analysis called automatic differentiation. Yeah, that makes sense. It's pretty much what we built. Okay, so that's cool now that we've got rid of the context, because it's actually just we instantiate a function. Actually, I should actually say an instantiation. Instantiation, like that? Is that how I spell it right? Probably not. But I didn't spell it right. Oh, I spelled it right. Cool. An instantiation of the function is the context. Oh, man. That sounds like a weird mantra. Mantra. Yo, I got stung by a mantra ray. Yeah, so look at, don't we love, so let me just show you guys how easy TinyGrad is to use. Well, so first off, maybe we should implement an optimizer. Should we implement an optimizer? Yeah, we probably should. All right, let's go back to yesterday's fun. Ugh. You guys gonna hack into, I'm gonna show you the token. You guys gonna hack into my shit? Who's gonna hack into my shit? Lol, you can't hack into my shit because it's on localhost. Yo, I'm just waiting for my quest to arrive. When's my quest get here? 264 viewers. Week. Oh, 549 viewers. Last week. All right, good. Wait, where's my quest at? That's a real question. Let me see. Is my quest here? Out for delivery. Now estimated. If they still arriving today by 9 p.m., they promised me between, you know, if you get upset about all the small things, you'll go through life outraged. You just want to work at a grocery store. Tahoe Dreams, thank you for subscribing. Let's check out this paper. What's the paper? What do we got? The simple essence. That's a lot of words for simple. No, I'm happy with my auto diff engine. My auto diff engine is sick. We just need to implement some. Well, let's look at what Torch's API is for it. Oh, they have a model.parameters. That's a little much. We don't need that, but we can just have, okay. Class SGD self tensors. We're probably going to want to make this more generic. Optimizer self.tensors equals tensors. We're also going to need a learning rate as an initialization parameter. And then we can say optim equals SGD. As an array, we got to put in model L1 and model L2. We also need to set our learning rate. Yeah, cool. Self.lr equals lr. Maybe we should support momentum first. What is the word for step? For t in self.tensors, t.data equals t.data minus equals lr times t.grad. I think that's right. Not a dgrad, just a grad. No, it doesn't even need, we can just, ooh, we can add the step here. So let's say optim.step. Boom. We don't even need zero grad because this is an even better library than PyTorch. That's right. Let's make sure our test still passes. Did somebody do a pull request yet for making the step takes zero positional arguments, but one was given. Oh, that's a tragedy. And of course we need self.lr. Don't be a noob. That's right. Let's go. Oh yeah, look at that. Write SGD class. Oh, we're gonna have to write Adam in a minute. Well, maybe first we should add momentum to our SGD. These are kind of just useful things. Maybe we should add them to like an NN class. Yeah, an NN class is probably nice. Okay, we'll do a little refactoring. We're gonna put this in tinygrad, nn.py. We'll say layer init, not tinybobnet, the optimizer definitely. And we'll add a fetch mnist. Fetch mnist, a very important part of any neural network class. Oh, you guys insisted on me having big text, and now I gotta move it over. All right, fine, we'll call it utils. Really, really, fetch mnist does not belong in here. From tinygrad nn import layer init sgd from tinygrad.utils import fetch mnist xtrain. Make sure the test still passes. NP is not defined. Lame. Oh, God, really? I did that? Yeah, high quality. Refactor into a few files. No, NN's a little aggressive. I don't like this. Never mind. Layer init can go back here. keep it at 2, you know, and then we're gonna not call this NN, we're gonna call this optim, just like torch import SGD. Actually, I can just say import tinygrad, can I? Can I? I'm not sure. I might have to put a nitpy here. Then we can just say tinygrad.optim.sgd, right? Does that work? Tinygrad has no object optim. Do I have to like tell it how to do that in... Oh, well, that's just because I want to do git mv tinygrad and then git mv tinygrad optim.py. Not in my test pass. I hate that mnist takes so long to load. Tinygrad has no attribute optim. Oh, fine. I think I do have to, I don't know, like this is like, I just don't know Python. From tinygrad.optim import sgd. That should work, right? If you guys want the GitHub repo to play along with tinygrad at home, please make sure if you like tinygrad and you think tinygrad is the future of all neural network libraries, make sure to give it a star. Oh, nice to see we got a pull request. Love it. Love it. Oh, yeah. Okay, cool. Oh, I found out why my mnist took forever. Look at that bug. What a stupid bug! Can't believe that was some noob shit! Good job, good job, good job, person. I'm proud of you. Wait, how does this work though if it doesn't install torch? Is this done? Let's go. Love it. Love seeing the hard work. Wow, that's why my mnist test took so long to start? Because I forgot a knot? Yo, don't forget your knots. Oh man, that starts so much faster now. Oh, that's so darn fish, darn fish, darn fish is cool. All right, good, 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 good. We can close this issue. It should automatically close the issue, right? No, it doesn't. Never mind. Yeah, you know, if someone wants to add a little badge to the README, I'd appreciate that. And if someone wants to implement grad check, we can just, I'll just read your code. So this one here, if one of you guys wants to write it, I would encourage somebody on the stream to write grad check, and then we can review it right here, live on stream. And then we're going to go, I'm going to do convolutions, and then I'm going to do add. Maybe we'll do add first. First we'll do momentum on SGD, then we'll do add. No, let's just do Atom. Never mind Momentum MySGD, that's boring. Okay, so Atom is a mad confusing optimizer that doesn't make any damn sense. But when we're done, we should be able to get this test. So we'll do some test-driven development here. We should be able to change this over to optim.atom, and that should just work. Torch optim atom. Let's make sure I matched my capitalization. Okay, cool. Shouldn't need as much learning rate for Atom. And now let's try our best to implement it. TinyGrad optim. Class Atom. Okay, I mean, I guess these optimizers all just inherit from something. Let's just see how Torch does it, and we'll do similar stuff. So they inherit from a class called Optimizer. Class Optimizer, all of that can probably live there. And then that can probably live there. And then actually, there's probably just a way that you implement. No, that seems to iterate through it all. Cool. We're not actually gonna. Well. Yeah, one of these days I'll actually learn Python and like know how to do this stuff. Super atom self dot init tensors LR. That's right. Is LR part of the optimizer? I don't think it is. It's just called params. I don't know. Never mind. I don't like this anymore. Whatever. Whatever, we don't have to match PyTorch perfectly. Okay. Oh, now thanks to Darnfish, it boots up so much faster. Okay, Atom has no step. We gotta add a step to Atom. All right, so let's read the really confusing, what is Atom? Maybe we should find the paper. Atom paper. Atom, a method for stochastic optimizations. Well, that's good, because that's what we're doing here. Perfect. Okay, so Atom has a whole bunch of stupid parameters. A is the step size, which is actually the learning rate. And we have a few more here called B1. B2 and eps self dot b1 equals b1 self dot b2. Yeah. You know, C++ has nice syntax for this. Okay. Whoa. Atom has time steps? No, that's ridiculous. Okay. Actually, I don't think this is tensors. I think we should call this params. That's what PyTorch calls it. I think it's more sensible. Because they're the parameters of the model. Okay, step. Get gradients with respect to stochastic objective. So that's the gradient. Okay, so we're going to have to update the biased first moment estimate. So we're going to have to initialize here. For t in self.params, first moment vector. I guess list. I'll just put them in the same order. V0 zeros like t t.data. Actually, we can write this in a neater way. All right, so we're not using dictionaries. We're just relying on the fact that they should be in the same order. This timestamp thing isn't actually used, is it? All right, so we have a suit. In order to take a step, let's say for IT in enumerate self params, we want to say self.mo equals self.b1 times self.mo sub I. Okay, this is a classic just update. Self.b1 times the gradient, which is just t.grad. This literally just means squared, right? Yeah, the element-wise square. Okay, that's fine. So for v0, well, actually, we should just call them m and v, because they're not really 0. Then we have this beta 2 parameter. Can you see that okay? It's just the previous gradient step. Yeah, so that's good. Compute the bias corrected first moment. We dislike bias here on this channel. We're, you know, inclusive of whatever, except I did still name my GitHub repo master, that's right. Because I personally want to be a Pokemon master. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be a Pokemon main. So that's it, you know. If you're a main Pokemon, that means you're the Pokemon who's being put in the ring. And Raichu shocks hurt. But if you're a master, if you're a Pokemon master, it means you're standing outside the ring telling your Pikachu to withstand the Thundershock. And, you know, that's just where I want to be, and I don't know about everybody else, but, you know, that's just who I am. That's me. That's right. Okay, cool. Oh, now we update the parameters. Oh, the parameters. Okay, good. T.data is the parameters. T.data equals T.data. Or just, I can just say minus equals, self.lr times the corrected estimate of the moment divided by, oh, I forgot the, got to square the gradients there. I think that works. Divided by parentheses v sub I. You know what? No, that's not right. Plus self.eps. Because we don't want that to go unstable. Cool. Is that Adam? Did I just write Adam? Is my Adam good? Let's check my Adam. You want to be Charizard. That's cool, man. Charizard's a cool thing to be. I think I'd rather be a Charmander. Oh no, no, invalid warning, overflow. Oh no, we messed up. Wait, why is there a T there? How'd that T sneak in? What's that T mean? Bias corrected. It did not learn. The loss went nan because my Adam game is weak. Yeah, you know what? The LR does not belong in the optimizer. LRs are not real things. The only thing real about an optimizer is params. Okay, yeah, well, that's why we shouldn't have used Atom. Let's switch back to SGD and see if it works. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, look, SGD, that's good function. Now we switch to Atom, and everything goes unstable. What a piece of crap. I don't know who wrote this. All right, let's read it more carefully. I probably read the paper wrong. All right, where are my bugs? Setting B0 and B1. Oh, to the power of T? Oh, holy shit, T is real. Yo, T is real. Self.t plus equals 1 here. Wow, to the power of T. Does not work. Why is there an overflow there? Is that really, does Atom really track the T? I guess that's just an optimizer parameter that gets loaded. Oh, we're gonna have to write loading and saving. Okay, that gets vanishingly small, which is fine. Oh, well, okay, so this is a tiny bug. We're going to say m hat, v hat, m hat, v hat. Oh, and I forgot to take the square root. We have so many bugs in here. Let's just say np dot square here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, too bad the test set accuracy is not higher. Oh, it was almost good. All right, let's try upping the learning rate a little bit. Don't up the learning rate. That was a mistake. We upped the learning rate, and that was a mistake. But if we compare the two learning rates, oh, that's pretty good, you know? Who thinks my Atom is right? I can't believe Atom actually tracks the time like that. How does this work? So this just looks like this is just normal momentum. But this is tracking the square of the gradients. Oh, is this just like the variance or something? BT to the power T. Gradients. That's probably right. Let's cut down on the number of steps. Let's compete on 100 steps. Oh, 92. All right, let's see what SGD gets. 88. Yeah, yeah, that's a way that Atom's better, even though it's kind of contrived. All right, so we can remove that from the to-dos. I think my Atom is right. And let's say 80% sure this is right. I mean, it works. Add support for Atom. Yeah, buddy. Adaptive moments. I'm not ignoring you. Imagine paying for an overpriced unfinished apartment. T T data needs the square root of V. All right, wait, I added the square root of V, right? I put the square root in, right? Square root of V hat, M hat, cool. Got to remove the bias. Is that all Adam is? Looks simple. Shouldn't it be alpha times M hat? Yeah. Well, I didn't use alpha, I used LR. That's the same idea. Pixloot, thank you for subscribing. Yeah. So 0xNan, you're right. I fixed that bug. M hat is not the same as M. Good, you guys spotted my bugs. Excellent. Vim is the best. Yeah, I should look at the chat. You spotted the M hat bug before me. All right. Good for you guys. Good. I'm glad to see people paying attention. I always appreciate people paying attention. I just think this is wild. That it's actually doing this. Let's do the PyTorch one. Let's see if it looks the same. Wow, okay. It's actually multiplying it by that. Oh, that's cute. They do late initialization on it. Wow. Okay, remind me to never use AMSGrad. If you use AMSGrad, it uses that much more RAM. You have to keep like an extra copy of your gradients around for that. State exp average squares. Okay, so they're calling their M mol beta 1 add grad alpha, what? Yeah, okay, I guess that's just the same xbav square, they multiply by beta 2, which is fine, and then they add C mol. Oh, crazy. What is add C mol? Torch has a lot of crazy stuff. Performs the element wise multiplication by tensor 1 by tensor 2. In other words, square the gradient and then multiply it by that. Okay, that's good. We're not an AMS grad. So we have the denominator. Decay them. Step size. Oh, wow, that's a much nicer way to write that. Like, you can just divide the LR by that, and then you don't have to multiply every stupid parameter. Yeah, and then they take the square root of both the top and the bottom. Yeah, it's a little faster, but it's not as readable. We go for readability over here in TinyGrad. If you want speed, consider PyTorch. which is very fast and beautiful.
Group and self-param groups.
When you calc MI, you must use MI minus 1. Yeah, well, that's what I'm doing, right? Oh, where'd my atom paper go? Yeah, I'm using the previous one, right? That is the previous one. Oh, can you guys only see my forehead? Am I messing up the camera? Is that better? How many viewers we got? We got viewers? Let's see if we got viewers. Viewers. Where's my viewers? It's in Twitch. Where's Twitch? I don't know. We have to use search. Live. Okay. Wow, if I take a 30-second break, I can run an ad and make money. I think. I don't really know. I'm not good at using apps, guys. I don't know who apps were made for, but it wasn't me. 688 viewers, that's pretty good. 700, 696, all right, sweet. Cool, where's my Oculus Quest? That's the real question. Where is it, Amazon? Did Mark Zuckerberg give you a call and be like, yo, Geohot's gonna jailbreak it, you better not deliver his Quest anytime soon. You ever heard of something getting lost in the mail? Yeah, Jeff, you can make it happen. It's safe inside the browser. Do you feel safe inside the browser? We're drinking Yak Jack, yo. It's the Yerba Mate. It's the craziest shit. We just wrote Adam, the best optimizer in the whole machine learning game, except for Adam W. If you're using weight decay, make sure to put your weight decays in the right place. Yo, let's understand Adam W. now. We can probably understand it now because we've now read the Adam paper and we understand it. We implemented Adam. Look at that. We implemented a beautiful Adam. So let's understand now Adam with weight decay. There was some like bug and people were doing weight decay wrong in Adam and it wasn't decaying the right thing. Oh, God, I got to plug it in. And then I feel that little tingle in my hand going through the metal case of my MacBook because somebody in this nuclear bunker didn't ground things well. Here we go. Okay. So this is Adam, and they added the weight decay here to the gradient, but we're supposed to add it over here after this in the M hat, because we decouple the weight decay from the gradient. Otherwise, all these gradient terms, who thought that was a good idea? Who thought you should put it there? Who put it there? I don't know. Some people can't be helped. Wait, but can I just like multiply that out? It's just weird to put it there too, because can I just multiply? What is N? Set schedule multiplier? What is this? Oh, this is like for learning rate schedules? But still, like, I can factor that out, and I can put that out there, and we multiply the learning rate times the weight decay, and what idiot put it there? That's clearly not the right place to put it. Oh, but, okay, I get what they're saying. It ends up there because of L2 regularization. Okay. If you're not, because there's no way to put things here unless you're inside the optimizer. That's smart. Ilya and, wait, Frank Hutter. Can't be related to Marcus Hutter, can you? No. Cool. All right, how we doing? Yeah, we can implement learning rate decay if we want, but we're not going to. We're just happy understanding what it is. And now we've implemented Adam, so we truly understand it. If you truly want to understand something, if you believe you understand something, implement it. And then you'll find out that you don't really understand it because you can't implement it. That's how I always learn, because I think I understand everything until I try to implement it. And then I realize that I don't understand. All right, let's see. How are you guys doing in pull request land on TinyGrad? How is TinyGrad? Oh, we got it. Ooh, test badge and read me. Oh, yeah. Perfect. Are my tests passing? I only want to merge this if my tests are passing. It would kind of be embarrassing if I merged it and my tests weren't passing. Merge. And we can close this issue over here. Close issue. Perfect. Oh, yeah. Look, we got unit tests. Does Micrograd have unit tests? And do they run in CI? These are the questions that we're asking. Micrograd doesn't have unit tests that run in CI. It does have tests. Maybe someone submitted a pull request for that. At higher order gradients. Wow. 362 changes. There is POW method. Why still needs this method? Just curious. POW requires second argument to be an int and float. Yeah, exp is just raised to the E. Cool. All right, who's writing grad check? Do we have to write grad check? We can write grad check. Can we do Q&A later? We just Q&A is part of the thing. If you want to ask questions right now, I got chat open. You know, you guys see when I have chat open now and you see when I'm paying attention to you. This is the new format. Who else can write TinyGrad? All right. Things we have to do. We have to implement grad check and we have to implement convolutions. Because if we don't have convolutions. Oh, you're attempting grad check. Okay, cool. That's good. You will get banned for stupid questions. That's true. You like this new format. Thanks, Linux with lots of underscores. All right, stupid questions. That's why chat goes away. When you guys ask smart questions, I'll keep chat around. What do we want to implement now? We want convolutions, because look at this. Lacoon MNIST. We want to get high accuracy. And once we get down here to convolutional neural nets, we can use LINET4. Let's take a look at LINET4. Oh, wow, this is a lot of... Who still draws convolutions like this? I don't know. But let's go back to MNIST from scratch quickly. And maybe we add some convolutions to BobNet. We'll move this over to develop over here. Accuracy is kind of weak. don't want to use NLL loss. Let's actually make this match. Instead of using loss function here, we're going to say torch dot... I have it in the tests. I have it in the test here. Functional large softmax. Yeah, let's do that. Out, and we can say multiply by minus y. Wait, log softmax with dim equals minus one? No, that's fine, but okay, that's good. What's Y shape? Oh, yeah, well, that's the problem. We want Y shape to be... Just do this for Y. The enemy is everywhere, yeah. Glen Rock, New Jersey knows what's up. So I don't exactly, okay, let's see. So is this different? Is that different from doing the NLL loss from here? Yeah, how are they different? Why is this different from that? Break something? Okay, now I broke something. Grad can only be implicitly created for scalar outputs. NLL loss dot mean. Alright, what'd I break? Is chat being shitty? Banned. You know, that's it. That's sometimes you just come down randomly hard on somebody and decide that, you know, them. All right, so we can just go there, go put that there like that. Y should be right. What did I break? Broke something pretty seriously, obviously. He just got banned. I don't know who's next. And the bannings will continue until chat stops being shitty. Oh, I set the batch size too small. Duh. You remember I was the guy who jailbreaked the iPhone? Oh yeah, timeout. We're here to talk about machine learning. Okay, so that works again. Now what if I go back to this one? Like, these are supposed to be the same thing. I should say minus YNLL, and that should really be. But they're different, and I don't really know why. Let's find the source of NLL loss and see what it is. Here we go. Forward. Great, just FNLL loss. Muzzle torch has no attribute F. NLL loss missing. Okay. So that is different compared to this. Why? I hate when it does this. It's like so many layers of code deep. All loss forward, oh, NLL loss forward CPU template. This is unreadable. I hate when they do this. Like, what is this? NLL loss out frame. Okay, here we go. Input ACC minus current weight. If current target equals ignore index, then output zero. Current weight if weight data is null pointer. Otherwise, weight data null target, and just does this get initialized to zero? Wait, otherwise it's always a one? Okay, output ACC equals input ACC sub cur target. I don't understand what target ACC is. Oh, that's just the target. Okay, so for each one of these, the target, the input sub that, just doesn't seem right. Why are those things not the same? We can print them out. Okay, well, the real NLL loss is clearly much larger. Maybe we'll get rid of the mean and see what we get. That. Which is in accordance with the batch size. Actually, I guess, you know what we really want to do is just calculate them both. Oh, okay. So the shape is different. It's doing an implicit sum there. So I guess if I really want to do that the same, I can just make it minus 10. And get rid of that. Those two things will be the same after the mean, I believe. Yeah, okay, cool. So in order to, yeah, and that's why I had to set my learning rate differently on my MNIST example in TinyGrad. But if we fix TinyGrad and we change this to minus 10, correct loss for NLL. Cool. That behaves almost the same. Does it actually behave identically? We should do random seed. So if I change that back to 001 and I switch that to that, does that work? That's the same. I'm not sure it's the same for all loss functions, though. It may actually be different for atom. Because before, when I changed the weight of atom to be higher, it broke. Pretty much the same. That's interesting, though, that it is the same. Correct loss for NLL. Torch NLL loss returns 1 per row. And we should really do the sum across there, because that's, I guess, what it does. Does it do the sum? Oh no, it just takes the subtraction of the current target. Okay, so it's just literally selecting. Fix NLL loss in example. Woo, hype train, level 5. Well, that was fast. Oh, now we're talking. I almost feel bad that I banned that guy. Maybe we should unban him. Wait. Oh, yeah, push though. Yeah, buddy. No mercy. Oh, yeah, you guys like no mercy, I guess. Oh, yeah, level 4 hype train. All right, yeah, get your subscriptions in now. Oh, wait, how did it get there so fast? Did someone, like, give a ton of bits? Did I miss someone who was nice? I just got 10k bits. Who gave 10k bits? Wait, I love the cakes, a spammer. Leeson, thank you. Thank you. Wow. Oh, I didn't even see those are bits. Oh, that's crazy. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, nice. I'm glad you guys are appreciating this content. We're back to programming. We got TinyGrad going on. We got any new pull requests on TinyGrad? Oh, we got a pull request. Make unit test run in all branches. All right. Wait, yeah, why did we only, do we have branches? I don't know. But that doesn't seem like a bad thing to merge. Let's go. Done. Okay. And actually, let me improve the README a little bit. You can even train neural networks with TinyGrad from test mnist.py. Let's add a little bit more flair here. Let's just copy some of the good stuff from here. The fact that it's so easy to just define a net. Let's make layering it a one-liner. Cool. I really want like a better one-liner for that. Complete like PyTorch. I think my layer in it's actually less readable. Update readme. Look, it's just like PyTorch. You know what else I was looking at that upset me? I messed up the tabs in this one. Oh, it's so ugly. That's unbelievably ugly. There's tabs. Someone let tabs go in. I hate tabs. It makes obvious sense that has to be minus 10, because if that was not minus 10, then if you added more classes, the loss would go down proportionally with your number of classes, which is not what you want. That is a broken categorical cross entropy. 100 dollars, wow, that's crazy. Looks very similar to TensorFlow. That's an insult. That is a deep insult. You're creating a tensor. We do make tensors. No, really, we want layer init should go in utils. And then that fixes my having to write layer init. We're gonna say uniform init. First, we're gonna copy from test mnist, layer init. I'm gonna call it layer init uniform. Because otherwise I'm calling functions in the README that don't really exist, and that's just rude. And we hate to be rude. Okay. Beautiful. Called it outs. It's kind of an ugly name. Just out is good. Really have to test it every time. If I do break it, then my CI test will tell me. Where's my Oculus Quest, you know? More README. Alright, I'm procrastinating convolutions because I have an idea that convolutions are really hard and that we're going to make this library impossible. Oh, but that's so beautiful. You can, like all of PyTorch, it's 150 lines. And what that shows is the amount of thought that they, how much the API matters. How much they, hello.
Are you streaming?
Yeah.
Oh my God, I just saw the most insane thing.
Was it a car crash? You bought big art.
It's entirely useless. Wait, I might need you.
Alex, didn't we talk about less stuff?
Okay, but it's really epic, George.
What is it?
We have a problem, though.
What?
Can you swap me some cash?
What is it?
It's a massive light sculpture.
How much cash do you need?
Just $100. Oh, actually,
do you know what?
I do not. I have $100. I have, well, it's a lot more than $100. I have, oh my God, I'm so excited.
Oh, yeah, you have all that cash.
Yes. Wait, it's huge.
Wait, how much
you
is
guys
this
are going to come move it.
How much is this light sculpture?
It's so cheap.
Wait, where did you and Lauren go?
Look, I'll be back and you'll get to see the sculpture in person.
Where did you go?
To this vintage store. Lauren's outside. I'm just gonna bring this check and look at her.
Why don't you invite her out?
Oh, because we have the movers in bed. They're picking it up.
They're picking up the thing.
The light sculpture. I'll be back in 20 minutes. With the giant light sculpture. Google Olafur Eliasson, the weather project.
You can't call a tensor class with one optimizer a library. I can because it has two optimizers. That's right. yeah, Alex is a paid actor. I pay her to come on my stream. Oh yeah, we were gonna write convolutions. PyTorch is 100 lines? No, PyTorch is a lot of lines. There's some parts of it that are confusing, but their APIs are really beautiful and simple. It's so beautiful. It's so well thought out. Geniuses, man. Geniuses made PyTorch. TinyGrad. Oh, we got another pull request on TinyGrad. Ooh, someone wrote grad check. Oh, holy shit, that's a lot of lines. You just copied grad check from PyTorch. You're a troll. All right, fine. You know what? Sorry for anyone who's writing grad check. I don't really want to write convolutions. We're going to write grad check. All right, let's start with the example. Let's see if we can get... No, the example's a little too simple. We're having the tests. Wow, that's a lot of crap. These tests are kind of crappy. Okay, that does look like it improved the tests. Why is this capital W? Why did I make the W capital? I'm gonna make the W lowercase. Capital W is too much. No, I like capital W. Yeah, capital W, that's a good capital. Oh no, the test failed once. Oh, by the way, the other thing that I was thinking... Did we normalize the mnests? I don't think we did. Where are my mnests? If I look at, like, xtrain sub zero... Oh, yeah, wow. I forgot that mnest... You know, like, I'm surprised that this worked, because we put ones. We didn't put, like, 255. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter, but that's why, like, the numbers were so weird. So I didn't multiply this by 255. Does it all scale perfectly? I guess it does. Yeah, it scales. So I wonder if that matters. I mean, technically we should renormalize it, you know? Oh, you know what? That might explain why the initialization's crappy. It got crappier. It's learning really slow now. So it learns fast with Adam. I'm gonna do that. Well, that's just because I didn't subtract it from there. That's worse too. I don't know. Seems like a big LR for SGD. Actually, the problem is the LR is too tiny. So, if we actually wanted a check, how do we write grad check? That's the model in Torch. I actually want to write grad check. Let's put that in. That doesn't have to go in there. I can actually go up here. Yeah, and I wanted to check. So if I do like something like, actually I can take an MNIST. And I can say model dot, what's in the README? Where's the README? X equals tensor model dot X test. Sampler. So, we're trying to compute D loss So then if we want the loss here, we say model sub x, out equals model sub x, and we copy the loss line here. Oops. Yeah, I had the right line there, I just didn't put the right line there. Good. Now I'm just going to get a loss, so I guess this one must be a 5. That's a 5, cool. You know it's a 5 because the loss is basically just this minus flipped around. Cool. This, but minus. So now, what we're trying to compute is d loss dx. Actually, not even d loss dx. We're trying to minimize loss so we can get like d loss dl1. Which is the gradient. So if I say loss dot backwards, we get the gradient here, like in the model, of I can say model dot l1 dot grad. And that's that. Yeah, okay, so let's look at loss DL2. Yeah, okay, that's just more accessible. Now, how would I do that? If I wanted to compute that numerically, how would I compute that numerically? I don't care. There's another tiny grad that stole my name, that went to the past and stole my name. Cute. I don't even know. Like how you do this kind of stuff numerically. And you, like, you can change the values a tiny amount and then run the forward pass and get something different. Oh, I mean, I guess. All right, so I guess what I can do, if I want to do this, is I can say something like x dot model L1 dot ReLU dot model L2 data. Well, maybe not even go that far. Why is that not using string? What should I do? It's a wrapper? Did I mean to write wrapper where I wrote string? That's what I want. Cool. So we want to figure out how to compute the model L2 grad. Which I think says for each parameter, how would we adjust it to change the loss function? If we wanted to change the loss function 1, given that that's our L2, here. So given that that's our L1, so we'll call this NX. And then we do like NX dot model L2. If we want to actually get the loss function, we continue it through log softmax like that. Okay, good. So now let's make a copy of model L2. Let's say FL2 equals model L2.data tensor copy. It's going to be the same. So according to this gradient, if I take FL2, 0, 0, and I plus equals it, this, I'm going to see a 1 change in the loss. Well, it's not exactly 1. Oh, wait, not a 1 change in the loss, but a learning rate change in the loss. Yeah, that's right. That's 0, but now if I add that there, okay, that's not the learning rate. Not the learning rate. That made the loss go up, but this will make the loss go down. Okay, so what determines the magnitude of that gradient? No, it should be 1. This shouldn't have anything to do with the learning rate. We haven't even done the learning rate yet. Okay, that's 0. That makes sense. If I add, yeah, it's big. Okay. So they're asking the question, and the gradient is the question about that matrix. Wow. So a learning rate of 1 would make the loss go to 0 on the batch. Oh, that's really cool. don't know how to get any of that stuff numerically. The magnitude of the gradient is the slope. Yeah, so I mean this is a the loss times one. How to implement gradients. Finite different approximation. You know, it's crazy that it's somehow with respect to the whole matrix. It's amazing that that works. It's not each value individually, it's literally the whole matrix. The gradients flow. Meh. I don't know. This is something to think about. But I think we made some good progress today on TinyGrad. Yeah. The magnitude is related to how fast the loss changes. It's just crazy that they're like all... they all move together. Yeah. Pretty happy with our library. I will do this, and I will do this. I'll probably do this one off stream because it involves a lot of thinking and sitting. Convolutions might be fun. What? Now there's some Lua? Just use his torch. Jacobian approximation. Yeah, that sounds right. How are you supposed to learn if I do it offline? You can follow the GitHub. All right. Any other questions? questions time. Only losers get master's degrees. Most people I know in master's programs are just there because Google will pay them an extra $20,000 for having a master's degree, and it's so incredibly sad. And it ruins the I mean, we were talking yesterday, like, is America still capable of producing great leaders? I mean, I'll tell you this, the great leaders aren't going to come from Harvard. How good should someone be in math? Well, you know, look at how bad I am at math. And I wrote a neural network library. It's called TinyGrad. Where do I see myself in 5 years, dead or homeless? Why isn't this called Pi George? I don't put my name in things. Would I consider raiding awkward chats today? No, we're not doing raids today. You have no choice in France. I've heard there's not freedom in France. Could you start all the way over? Nope. The best leaders are those that don't want to be in leadership roles. Yeah, that's probably true. But today they're like, well, everyone's a leader, you know? How do you create good leaders? What is it? What is the old saying? It's like, good times create weak men create bad times create strong men create good times, and the cycle starts over again. Yeah, unfortunately, that's what I think it is. When am I coming to Rotterdam? When they let me in. A master's is 100% needed. What? I'll hire you, I don't care. Apparently a morning routine in a journal. Would you read that? Huffington blog post? You read that on what's those websites? You know? Business Insider? Yeah, that one, yeah. I did join a stream. I stayed around Linux for a little bit. Weak men create bad times. You are here. Yeah, that's the truth, right? That is the truth. What's the hairy ball theorem? Should I Google that? I feel like I shouldn't Google that. If you were a subscriber, I'd Google it. Can you explain how multi-head attention works? I wrote it. I wrote a multi-head attention, didn't I? In my Transformer edition? Yeah, here you go. Sadly, I wrote it with TensorFlow, but yeah. Yeah, TensorFlow sucks. Don't use TensorFlow. I've wasted so much of my life on TensorFlow. Oh, my private Wikipedia. What, I downloaded Wikipedia? No, from the transistor, probably not. What's bad about TensorFlow? It takes 5 minutes to start up. The code's impossible to read to fix anything. And it uses all the RAM of your GPU. TensorFlow is just a library written to consume resources. So the Google data center team would have something to do. UBI is a bad idea. This was in the Grey Mirror of the Nihilist Prince. It's like, an economy where five people stick a pipe in the ground and everybody else lives off of government checks does not make a good economy. You know, look up the curse of natural resources. Does it really matter if the resources are natural or 50 guys writing software? I did read some of Hero with 1,000 Faces. I couldn't get that into it. Downloading RAM is a great idea. Or you can just compress your RAM. Just compress your RAM. Why not compress it? It turns out like the countries without natural resources do better than the countries with natural resources. It's a curse. This is a classic. Like, political science thing. What are A6000s? I mean, yeah, no, one of the downsides to having resources is, yeah, other people are going to want to come steal your resources. That's definitely true. I'm not sure, though. I'm not sure. I'd like to see that controlled for. They're A6000s? I mean, A100s? What games will I play on the Quest? None if I can't get past the Facebook login. A6000s or ATIs? Oh, I've never even seen this one. Oh, it's an RTX. Oh, they make a blower and then they don't open the back of the GPU? That's terrible. San Francisco's over. Everyone's left. We'll see. I'm not sure where the next one's gonna be. It's very sad what's happened. Now blowers are beautiful, but the problem is they don't have the stuff there. SF was always shit. I mean, I don't know. I feel like it was a lot better 10 years ago. I feel like there's, for example, I moved to Mountain View in 2008. I paid $700 for a room. Almost everybody I met at Google was talented. And they're really because they love technology. Today, you move to Mountain View, it's probably $2,000 to rent that same room. And you go to Google and there's a whole lot of people who are like, oh, I'm only gonna be here for a year. They're paying me $400,000. What do you need the RAM for? Just to accumulate gradient. I don't want RAM, I want RAM bandwidth. Princess of the Yen, no. Who cares about the iPhone 12? All right. Will I post pic of statue? I do not know statue. Thank you all for watching. Have a nice day.